Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a rope brush in Adobe Illustrator and use it on your typography. So let's get started. First, create a new artboard. The size really doesn't matter. Zoom in on the artboard and with the rectangle tool, create a rectangle like this. I'll increase the stroke a bit. 10 would be fine. Okay. With the direct selection tool, select the top right corner and the bottom left corner and make these corners like this. Now select the design with the move tool and you can rotate it like this with holding down the shift key 45 degree, or select the design and double click on the rotate tool. Type 45 and click on OK. This will be our rope base. And now we will add some details inside the rope. For that, I will select the pencil tool. Double click on the pencil tool. Make sure the fidelity is to smooth. Then click on OK. Then draw a line like this. This one is much better. Then on the stroke option, the caps should be rounded caps, and change the uniform to this one and move it a little bit inside because our stroke was showing outside. Now you can copy this thing and make some more, or you can draw your own. I will just make copies of this one. Okay, it looks good. Select all of them. Go to object, path, outline stroke. It looks good. Now we need to change the inside color to a little bit grayish. Don't put too much black color in there. It's fine. Select all of them. Control G for group. Then go to the swatches panel. My swatches panel is over here. If you don't see this, go to window, then swatches. You will see the swatches panel. Then select this design and drag and drop on the swatches panel. You will see over here right now we have a new swatches with the design. So I will put it over here. Then now double click on the new swatches icon. Now it will show our pattern options. We will reduce the width. We'll make it more closer. Okay. Something like this. This one looks good. Then close this window and click on save a copy. New palette, you can give it a name. I will just leave it as it is and click on OK. Okay. Then click on done. And now our new palette is created. I'll just click over here and drag and drop it over here. Okay, this is our new rope design. Now right click on it and ungroup it. Now select the rectangle. This is not showing up. Fill it with some color. Then select all the designs. Now select the shape builder tool and remove the extra areas. The areas outside of this green box. I will delete all of those. Holding down the Alt key, this will cut the extra areas. Okay, this looks fine. Now we'll delete this one. Select it, Control G for group. Now go to the brushes panel. If you don't see this, same procedure. Go to window and then brushes and drag and drop it over here on the brush panel. Select the pattern brush and click on OK. For the corner, we need to change some corners. So check which one looks best on your situation. I'll select this one. And for this, I'll leave it as it is. And for this corner, I may choose this one. or this one. Yeah, this one is much better. Then I will click on OK. Now I'll leave all of them. You can delete those if you want to. I'll leave those as it is for now. Select the brush. And with this pattern selected, you can draw now. As you can see, this is our brush. So let's see how we can use it on our design. So over here, as you can see, we have typed rope. Let's just show you how I make the rope text and the R1. With the pen tool, I just draw R shape. Something like this. You can take your time and make the design a little bit better. I'm just showing up you over here. So let's ungroup it and show you the actual path for this. Over here, as you can see, this is the path. After the path creation is done, just click on the pattern brush. It will make your any path into a font. You can create any type of text with the rope. One more important thing is if you want to change the color of the rope, for example, right now, sorry, not this one, the stroke color. If you want to change the stroke color, as you can see, my one is changing. Your one may not change. For that, you have to do just double click on the brush and choose. Your one will be none. Choose tint. That will allow you to change the color with the color tint. Now you can select any brush and choose any color that will be changed to that color tint. And this is how you can create a rope brush in Adobe Illustrator. If this video is helpful for you, give it a thumbs up. If you have any question, you can always ask me on the comment section. I will see you on the next video.